Yeah, that the requirements for the position were assembled by the current board of Eskom, whom even the presidency has declared is not competent. And that criteria doesn't include the requirement for an engineer. I would have thought that anything less than an engineer running Eskom would be looking for more disasters. Everybody deserves a chance if you've gotten through a process. But the bottom line is it's a very, very chalice position in that he hit the ground. He won't hit the ground running because he's not an engineer. And secondly, he's got to implement a strategy which is not his own, which has been foisted upon him by the Eskom roadmap that was put together by government about 2 weeks ago. So not only is he going to hit familiar territory, but he's going to have to implement a strategy that he himself has had no hand in designing.